Hey everybody, how's it going? It's John from Hascasts, helping you into the world of home automation, one simple step at a time. Right, so what I'm going to talk about today is I'm going to talk about and walk you through how to install node-red on has.io, the simple way. Okay, let's get to it. First of all, you'll have to excuse me, I'm battling cold stroke flu at the moment, so this video will be very choppy. Right, okay, let's begin. So if we go into the has.io tab panel and go into the addon store, we can see that currently there is... Okay, if we have a look in the left-hand menu and in the add-ons repository at the bottom of the screen, you will see that I quite obviously have Node-RED installed on this virtual machine. So I will uninstall the repository and reinstall it to show you how that's done. However, the entry in the left-hand menu will remain there. You just got to bear with me. Okay, back to the video. Right, so if we look inside our current addon store, you will see that there is no option to install Node-RED. However, there is a third-party repository available. Now, I will post this link, which is the instructions on how to install it. I'll put a link to this site in the description below. Right, so it tells us what to do, basically. Add my has.io add-on repository. So if we click on that, that will take us to this site. Scroll down, and we find a URL. Copy that. Go back into Home Assistant, and we want to add a new repository. Paste that repository in. Right, and now that is added, we will see at the bottom of the screen we have Node-RED. So let's have a look to see if there are any further instructions that we need to worry about. Right, so this is basically going through the configuration. So this is giving us, I'm just going to copy that now. This is giving us a bit of a configuration to go in our config file, and that will allow it to come up in the sidebar as such. So I've copied that now. I have not yet used the Node-RED dashboard. It looks quite good. I'll save that for a future episode. Right, so now let's go back to our system. Right, so Node-RED. It also gives us the configuration here. Okay, so let's install it. Right, okay, so that's installed. Right, so we want to select start on boot, and we want it to auto update. Now if we have a look for the configuration, here it is, it's at the bottom. Right, so remember, if you want SSL support, change that to true and select your relevant files. For users, if you are like me and you're just on a local host only, it's not connected to the outside world via anything like Duck DNS, Dyn DNS, or anything like that, then you can just delete the entry for the user's authentication. However, if your system is open to the world, as in if you are using Duck DNS or Dyn DNS or any sort of DNS forwarding tool, then I recommend you add this, add a password, So for permissions, you could leave it as star asterisk, which means read, write, or permissions, delete. Or if you just want somebody to be able to read, then you could change the star, the asterisk, to read. So like I said, I'm not going to enter a username and password, so I'm just going to delete that. And exactly the same for HTTP node user. Not something I'm worried about. I am, however, going to try projects. Don't quite know what it is at the moment. Right, let's save that. Okay, it's instant save, I forgot about that. Scroll up to the top and start. Now, if we go into configurator, I forgot I did add the admin and admin for the configurator, which I do need to take off. Right, now that we're in configurator, if we scroll to the part where we have our panel iframe entries, you can see here I've got configurator, the IDE, which I've not gone through yet, and node red floors, which is what I copied and pasted from the website earlier. However, I've changed the IP address because I'm not running a Raspberry Pi, I'm running inside a virtual machine. So I've changed hassio.local to the IP address of the virtual machine. As we can see here, HTTP 192.168.0.5.2. Right, okay, no need to save that. And here we are. Now, we haven't got anything installed yet, but it gives us a quick introduction. Hello, we have introduced projects to Node-RED. Alright, okay. This is a new way to let you manage your flow files and include a version control. Awesome. Awesome, awesome, awesome. I was thinking earlier while I was using it on my system that I could do with some version control. Okay. To get started, you can create your first project or clone an existing project from a Git repository. If you are not sure, you can skip this for now. You will still be able to create your first project from the Projects menu at any time. Pardon me. Okay, I'm going to click Not Right Now. And if we have a look, we have, so by default, we have inputs, outputs, functions, some social, and a few more. Ah, awesome. So we do have the Home Assistant stuff by default. Right, so why don't we say, just as a quick example, don't know why I've done that, it's the only flaw. Okay, so let's get the current state. So get some state. I may have to, that's fine. So this is awesome. It already has the Home Assistant server entered by default. And there we go. So sun.sun. And I'm going to push that onto a debug statement. So that will come up here. Okay, so let's deploy that. That is now saved. So this is fantastic. Before, when you had to create the automations and the scripts in Home Assistant, even when the GUI was added, you then had to go and restart something, either restart the automations, restart the script, or even restart the server. Now you don't. You just click deploy, and it's fantastic. Okay, right. Okay, I haven't put in an input, so there's no way to start it yet. So let's connect that. to that, deploy it, and what this will allow us to do, basically it allows us to have it go off at certain times, so at intervals, at specific times, but the handy bit is this one here, which will just push the floor through when it's pressed. So it's going through there, it's gone to get the state, and it is showing us the payload, which is below horizon. That is the state in Home Assistant at the moment. Right, so how is it for you? Make sure if you've got value from this video, give it a like. And if you've got any comments, questions or queries, leave a comment, question or query in the comments section below. If you want to see about installing has.io so that you can do it the simple way, then you need to be looking up there. And if you have not subscribed yet, then if you look up there, you will see a has.io circular logo. Hover over it, the subscribe thing will flow out to the left, and then just hit that subscribe button. That's it for today. Thank you.